Hello and welcome back to the beautiful world of SpoderCraft. Full of tons of awesome buildings and stuff. Yeah, and a chicken that just pooped out an egg. Woohoo! Anyway, we're back, and today we have a lot of very important things to do. We're cleaning up the town. There are tons of creeper holes and other stuff that just needs to be fixed. And I'm gonna do it. Okay, so in this time-lapse recording, I'm gonna be talking about all the people that have been joining the server in the past few days. So, as you may know, finally, Kuna has stepped down and given in from leading his village and has joined our village so that our village is cooler and his village only had one person, him. So he is finally joining. He is building his house. Also, Parsy Peevesy, who has been featured in a few of my videos already, has joined and has built a ton of stuff, including a shop. And finally, soon, a new person, my good friend that I've known my entire life, I can't say his real name, Red Seats is his username, and he is joining the village also, and the realm, so he's gonna be in a bunch of videos, and it'll be really awesome. He is really great at building, and some redstone, other stuff. So yeah, it'll be great to have him on the server to add to our ever-growing village. So, yeah, that will be great. So I'm mining stone right now because I need a lot of stone bricks to make the pathways through the village and around to all the houses. So the plan I have is just going to be a simple, two stone brick wide pathway that will connect, my house, Parsy's house, the Blah Maples' houses, Harpy's house, and the dojo and the pagoda. I'm also thinking that I want to, connect it to the edge of the village. And also, maybe add some sort of, some sort of enchanting, like shared enchanting room area, and fix the enderbank because it looks terrible, and maybe make the mine look nicer. I really want to add stairs to the mine and make it so you don't bump your head on the ceiling because it's really annoying, and it's driving everyone insane on the entire server. So, yes, that I also want to get to. Also, I want to start building some cool, like, redstone contraptions, like redstone farms, and cool stuff like that. So, yeah. So now that we have all the ingredients we need and everything else, let's start with building the pathways. So, as you can see right now, I'm placing in all the stone bricks, and all the paths and everything. So, these paths will connect everything in the village. It'll be much nicer to walk around, and you won't have to, like, parkour around to get places. Just overall, a much better experience in the village. Also, we'll add lighting so that creepers stop blowing up every single thing in the village. And we're gonna add a shopping district. It's going to be in, like, it's the area, like, behind the mine, sort of. Like, diagonal from the mine and Parsy's shop. His sugarcane shop. like, there's just like a big open space between the mine and the water elevator that goes up to Parsi's house. And we're going to put the shopping district there. So I know Parsi is selling sugarcane. I think Kuna is going to sell like leather clothes. Not sure why. I'm not sure what I'm going to, I don't know what I'm going to sell. So leave your comments about what I should have in my shop. Maybe I could make like a slime farm and sell slime. Or just redstone stuff. I don't know. Because I know I can't sell food because Parsi has an infinite supply of fish. Because he goes AFK every night. Can't sell enchanted items because there's already that in the middle chest. Also, just about now you can see me, maybe about here, you can see me doing a trade with Parsi. We're trading enderpearls and stuff. So I was thinking I could make a nether and end shop. So when we defeat the ender dragon, which might be pretty soon, I'll sell all nether supplies, stuff like that. When the nether update comes, I'll sell like nether, I mean, probably not netherite because it's super valuable, but I can sell like the new woods, the new block supplies, and all the old nether and end stuff. Like eventually maybe shulker boxes after we go end busting, which will be a very fun episode. I can't wait to do that. So yes, Parsi's been talking about trying to defeat the ender dragon soon. I think that after Red Seats joins and gets a bunch of diamonds and stuff, we all have pretty good stuff. I think we're gonna go and fight the ender dragon, and well, we'll see how it goes.
Okay, so we have placed in all of the stone bricks. There's pathways going all the way to all the parts of the village, up to Parsi and Kuna's places, to Blah Maple and Blah Maple II's houses, all the way to Harpy over there, to the dojo, which I don't think you've seen the interior yet. But it is very cool. Inside of the dojo, I think a Blah Maple built this. Oh no, a Zumbi. Die, Zumbi. Oh no, I'm lagging. Okay, now the Zumbi is dead. Okay, but look, it looks pretty nice, right? He even posed all the statues. Looks really cool. Okay, so, yeah. So we have stairs going up there. Paths going over to the central area. And, we don't have the paths yet, but over there is going to be the shopping district, so we'll move the sugarcane farm. We also have now an enchanting area, the doghouse for my adorable dog Tag, and I made the ender chest look nicer. This way goes up to the pagoda, like this. There's a water bubble elevator, and those stairs go to the edge of the village, the boundary, which we may expand. So yeah, that's what we've done. Another thing that I've done, in this time, I forgot to record doing it, but, up here, if you go up this water elevator into the pagoda, or the town hall, I made a courtroom here, and the really cool thing is, turn the volume up a bit, so the judge here, this is supposed to be a gavel, and if you rotate it, it makes a sound, like a gavel smacking against the table or something. Also, there's a sign-up board. We don't have any events right now, so that's irrelevant. Here, I made a Shinto shrine and some chairs and stuff, because it's supposed to be an ancient Japanese-style village. This is supposed to be some sort of embassy area. We have the two village banners, a Midnight Sun Village and village in this hidden stone. And up here is just storage. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So we did that. Oh, and the way to get down, you just follow these stone bricks. Whee! And there's a diamond over there. You can't get killed by that. So yes. Also, I think we should add some sort of lighting around the village, around the pathways, because it gets really dark and there are creepers everywhere. That's why we had to fill in all those holes earlier. So yes, let's do that now. Here it is. Here's the town now. I put all the lights in. It's pretty simple lighting. And now, this is it. There's Parzi's house. The Blah Maple's houses. Harpy's house. My house. Kuna's house is up there. The pagoda. The edge of the village. The town square. The shop. And the dojo. It's all visible from right here. It's a really good view of everything. And eventually, the shopping district right over here, and a new person, Red Seed's house. I don't know where he's gonna live, but he'll be somewhere in the village. It really is beautiful. So yeah, that's the village. Oh no! How did I only take 3 hearts of damage? Feather falling really is broken. My skeleton. Here's the mine. Everything in the town square, all lit up. All the pathways to all the houses. The water streams. It's just so much nicer with the pathways. And another thing that I made in my house, because there was a little area and I wanted to fill it with something. Made a little aquarium. Look at it, it's so cool. There's a bunch of corals and kelp and some little fishies swimming around as I eat fish. So cute. But yeah, there's an aquarium and everything else here. So I think that's all we're gonna do in this video. So yeah, that's it for now. I'll see you later. Bye.